morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning, good morning. We're gonna let that just play just a little while longer. Come on into the live. Come on into the live. Come on into the live, everybody. Come on into the live. Tag everybody, like, share, start a watch party. It is Sunday Live. It's Life Church International. Come on, let's celebrate because he's done a great thing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Listen, good morning. It is Sunday morning here at Life Church International. I'm so very, very glad that you have tuned in. Text somebody, text someone, like, share, start a watch party so that we can be gathered together for this Sunday service here at Life Church International. Don't just hear me say that. Actually, click the share button right there on your screen. Click it and just share this wherever you are and to whomever may be your friends on Facebook so that they can tune in with us to receive exactly what God is going to give to you. I'm so glad you're with us. If you're with us and joining us for the very first time, I am Pastor Jay Marcellus Williams and the senior and founder of Life Church International, the greatest church on this side of heaven where we exist to win souls and to change lives. So very glad that you are with us. We're going to pray in a moment and we're going to do our scriptures and just kind of get ourselves gathered and ready to receive everything that God has for us. I am certainly glad that you are with us. You are with us this morning. I want you to know that God has something great for you this morning. This morning. All right, listen, let's go ahead and go to our scriptures. I'm sorry, to our prayer. Pray with me, please. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you for another day's journey. Thank you, God, that we can still feel your presence. Thank you, God, that even though we are not always as close to you as we want to be, you still allow us those small little confirmations that let us know that you're still with us. Thank you, God. Such an amazing grace that you give unto us. God, is such a powerful blessing to have a personal relationship with you. And so, Father, we just simply tell you thank you in the name of Jesus. God, we've gone through another week of your blessings, another week of your grace, another week of ups, and another week of downs. And we're still yet thankful, God, thankful that no matter what we've gone through, we have actually gone through it. And we're still here to talk about it, still here to testify that even though we have gone through some things, you are still a good God and we are still a blessed people. And so, Father, we tell you thank you in the mighty, matchless name of Jesus. Father, we lift up before you this amazing church and everyone that is watching me right now and tuning in to receive from you. You know exactly what they need. You know what they're going through. You know what they are listening for. Father, I pray speak to every situation right where they are, on the level that they are, that they may know, God, that you are their God. And even in this corporate setting, you are still their personal God who is concerned about their personal issue, Father. I thank you, God, that there's no illness that can stand in such presence. God, heal now in the name of Jesus. There's no depression that can remain in such presence. Give joy now in the name of Jesus. No storm can remain in such presence. Give peace now in the name of Jesus. We thank you and we give you praise. In Jesus' name we pray, amen, amen. All right, again, like, share, and start a watch party. This is Life Church International. So glad that you're listening. Take a moment and go ahead and just say good morning to somebody. Somebody you see, say good morning, speak, and just greet everybody that is here on the live with you. You want to interact. You don't want to just sit and look. Get up out the bed. Get up out the bed. Don't get too comfortable. Matter of fact, get up and be aware. Be very alert so that you can get exactly what God has for you. Come along with me and let's go to our scriptures and let's declare with power and with conviction the scriptures that God gives us to declare over our life and over our living every single week. Our first scripture is Amos 9 and 13 in the Message version. Let's do it together. Ready, go. Yes, indeed, it won't be long now. God's decree. Things are going to happen so fast, your head will swim. One thing fast on the heels of the other, you won't be able to keep up. Everything will be happening at once, and everywhere you look, blessings. Blessings like wine pouring off the mountains and hills. Type right here in the comments, everywhere I look, blessings. Come on, type right here. Type, type, type. Everywhere I look, blessings. Those of you who are listening to me from the conference call, I want you to declare it in your atmosphere. Change the energy in your atmosphere and shout, everywhere I look, blessings. Hallelujah. All right, let's go to our second verse, Proverbs 4 and 25 in the Message version. It says, keep your eyes straight ahead and ignore all sideshow distractions. I want you to type, I am focused. Yep, declare it, that I am focused. Keep your eyes straight ahead. Ignore all sideshow distractions. I can do that because I am focused. Hallelujah. All right, our last verse, remember now, I changed it up a little bit for us, and we're going to Matthew 9 and 29. It's actually in the King James Version. Here it reads, then touched he their eyes, saying, and I'm going to flip it, be it unto you according to your faith. Be it unto you according to your faith. Come on, I want to say it again. Be it, whatever it is, unto you according to your faith. I want you to type right here, my faith got it. Come on, type right here, my faith got it. Come on, I don't see it. Type, my faith got it. Be it unto you, whatever it is, according to your faith. Hallelujah. All right, so I have a great message for you today. I think it's a very special word for you today that I believe is straight from God. Let's pray very quickly. Father, thank you for your word. Thank you for those who are gathered to hear your word. I pray that you will use me to bless all of us, even myself, through your Holy Spirit speaking through me the word of God for our life and for our living. In the mighty, matchless name of Jesus, we pray, amen. All right, so over the last 2 weeks, we've been talking from the subject, from seed to bloom, from seed to bloom. And I shared with you that this is from the thought process of taking control of your thoughts, taking control of your mind. For the Bible says in Proverbs 23 and 7, that as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. His heart refers to his mind. And if you can win the battle first in your mind, then you can win the battle everywhere else subsequently. So it's about taking control of what comes in your mind and taking control of what your mind is thinking. If you can think it, you can do it. Now, in May 2020 of this particular year, God gave me a very poignant and special word. And I want to share that word with you. Actually, I'm going to kind of let you in on some private things as it relates to how God spoke to me way back in May. And God will speak to me on occasion. And I may not share it right away because I have to make sure I know what God is saying, and then I have to just allow myself to live what it is that I'm going to teach before I start teaching it. Because if you haven't cooked it up, then you don't really know how it tastes yourself. So I wanted to wait until God released me to be able to release this word for you. Where I work, I serve as a chaplain in a local hospital here in Jacksonville, Shands Hospital. I've been sharing there for the past 7 years. And in the hospitals, for security purposes, they require us employees to change our password at least twice a year, just for security purposes. And so because I had to change it so much, I had to kind of get creative of the passwords that I was using. And so I would actually make that a God moment for me, where I would sit and think and ask God, what should I put in this password? And God began to give me prophetic phrases that would be the trajectory of my next season. And so some of my passwords was go now, keep going, and others like that, almost there, forward, or whatever the case may be. And I've been doing them now for like that, at least for the last 5 years. This particular time, around May of this year, I did the very same thing. It's time to change your password. So I asked God, okay, what should my password be? God gave me one word. Let me say this. Every time God gave me a word, it came to pass within that season. And it became a prophetic thing for me. God gave me a word this May, and it's been coming to pass, and I'm giving you this word for your life and for your season. And the word that God gave me for my password was transition. God gave me the word transition. And if you just take a moment, just from May, of course, you probably could go all the way back to March, but just take from May of this year. That word has fully manifested itself over and over and over again in, I would say, definitely a corporate setting. And then I'm sure that some transitions have been happening to you privately and personally. Transition after transition after transition after transition in a corporate setting, like the children being out of school and then now having to be virtual. It's a transition. Having to quarantine, transition. Having to work from home, transition. People dying suddenly, rapidly, in great numbers, transition after transition after transition. People all of a sudden losing their jobs, transition. People being hired on new jobs, transition. It's been transition after transition after transition after transition. And I gotta be honest with you that was kind of scary to me because I was thinking of it from such a negative standpoint. Transition, oh, what's going to happen? And I kind of got nervous, but I always know, right, that when God speaks a thing and he prepares you for a thing, it's always for your better. It's always for your good. For we know all things work together for the good of them that love God and those who are the called according to his purpose. So we know all things work together for our good. For the Bible says in Jeremiah 29:11, for I know the thoughts that I have for you. These are thoughts to bless you, to prosper you, and to give you the great expected end. So even if God, and God has, I want you to listen to me from a prophetic standpoint today as the messenger of God for your life, that God has spoken a word for you for this season that you're in. And that word is prepare for transition. Transition. Seed to bloom. From seed to bloom. In order for that seed to become a blossomed, resulted flower or fruit or tree, it has to go through a transition from it being a seed to it being its blossomed end. Now, there's a difference. Transition is different from process. Process is the acts that must take place on a journey. Transition is the different shape, the different altered transactions that must happen on your journey. You can transition while you're going through the process, but are different things. Process is the journey. Transition are the alterations on that journey. That seed will have to go through a transition to where once it comes out in bloom, it will look nothing like what it looked like going in. Never do you look at an apple seed and say it looks like an apple. An apple seed doesn't look like an apple. An orange seed doesn't look like an orange. The seed never looks like its results. What happens? How does it come from a goofy looking speck to a nutrient object? It takes a transition. And I'm actually going to be very simple today because I want to be impactful, so I'm not going to be long. I'm going to give you what God gave me, and I think just giving it to you and leaving it there is going to be most impactful for you, opposed to me trying to preach it out and explain it out. Because here's what I believe God is going to do for you. I want you listening to me very, very carefully. God is going to have the Holy Spirit within you walk you through what this means for you. It's not going to be just in a sermon, but he's going to walk this through for you on a daily basis. And he's going to show you the transitions that he has already planned and plotted for you. Now, here are four things that you're going to have to do in being successful and blessed in your season of transition. Number one, you're going to have a certainty of God's voice. In this time of transition, it is vitally important that you know the voice of God. It's vital. The Bible says that there is safety in the multitude of counsel. So you can have people around you, mentors, spiritual advisors, spiritual fathers, friends, confidants, family, mother, father, whomever it may be that you talk to. And that's nothing is wrong with that, because the Bible does say that there is safety in the multitude of counsel. But in this season, you need a certainty of God's voice in your life. You need to know when he is talking to you as you make this transition. Number two, not only do you need a certainty of God's voice, but you also need a clarity of vision. Where am I going? What am I purposed for? How do I get there? I'll say that again. Where am I going? What am I purposed for? And how do I get there? You need clarity of vision. You cannot waste time wandering around, trying to try this, try that, and trying to figure it out. You need to know clarity. You have rather clarity of vision. Know where you're going, so that as you begin to embark on it, you know what it looks like. You know what it's supposed to look like. Your relationships, your career, your finances, your mental capacity, your emotional capacity. Have a vision for all those things. So that anything that doesn't look like what God gave you in your vision, then you automatically know, I don't waste time on this. I don't waste time on this person, because I have clarity of vision. This is your season of transition. You need a certainty of God's voice. You need, number two, a clarity of vision. You need, number three, to have boldness of faith. You need boldness of faith. Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17, says, for we walk by faith and not by sight. I need to get that in your spirit. For we walk by faith and not by sight. That's why you need to take control of your mind, because fear is going to try and grip your mind. But you need a boldness of faith, that you walk by faith. What is faith? Faith in what? Faith in the clarity of God's voice. Faith in the certainty of God's voice. Faith in the clarity of your vision. Have faith, boldness of faith. And then not only do you need a boldness, let me pause there for a second. In having a boldness of faith, This transition that you're going to have to encounter is not going to be easy, in that it's going to challenge your mind more than is a hard, difficult task. It's going to challenge your mind because it may not look like what you want it to look like. It may not come the way you want it to come. It may not feel good. When what God is doing is in this transition is preparing you for even greater. For we go glory to glory, faith to faith, from height to height. We go up from here to there, and we keep going up. You don't go down to God. And so you need boldness of faith. Watch this carefully. When you know about the story of the eagle stirring the nest, you get to a point to where God is saying, this season of your life where you've been, I have called it to close. And I've got to push you out of this season to get you over into the next season. For most of us, if God doesn't give us that push, we'd never go, because we don't want to get pushed out of our comfort, out of our comfortability. Because that then challenges us to have to do something more than what we've probably done before, or be exposed to some things we haven't been exposed to. Let me give you this, a very simple example, then I'll move on. My children, especially as they get older, my oldest daughter is just about at that age. I want them all to get out of my house. And so with that, my oldest daughter is 17, she'll be 18 very soon. I know she's not ready to get out in the world yet, but there will soon come a time, very soon after she's of the age of being grown, that she's going to have to get out on her own. So what I'm going to do as a father is I'm going to, all of my children, I'm going to walk them to the edge of the cliff. While we're walking to the edge of the cliff, I am preparing them with wisdom, with knowledge, with lessons. And I'm going to supply them with as much as money as I can supply them with, which much as good foundation of material things that they need to supply them with. And that's us taking that journey to the edge of the cliff. And we're going to slowly get to the edge of the cliff, slowly get there. And I'm going to walk with them, and my wife are going to walk with them slowly, step by step, hand in hand. And we're going to all get to the edge of the cliff together. And once we get to the edge of the cliff, then I'm pushing them. I'm pushing them over the cliff. Because for most of us, if you don't get that push, you'll never fly. And then once you get that push, now you got to have boldness of faith. And here's the last one you got to have. Once you get that push into this next season of your life, you need to have discipline of work. The Bible says in James chapter 2, verse 17, here's what it says. We know this verse is very, very familiar verse. James chapter 2, verse 7, it says, in the same way, faith, if it doesn't have works, is dead by itself. Faith without works is a simple fleeting hope. Oh, I hope this happens, or I hope I get a job, or I hope I get married, or my marriage gets better. I hope it's a fleeting thought. So you got to take, Bible says, faith is the substance of things hoped for. You got to take that faith and the evidence of things not seen. You got to take that faith and you got to add works to it, and then it becomes tangible. In this season where God has called for a transition in your life, it is time for you to now have a discipline of work. I need you to work like it depends upon you, but pray and have faith like it depends upon God. God has spoken to you. Transition. This is your season to transition. I admonish you to believe God in that, because this is not a negative thing. No matter how it feels, God has nothing but greatness for you. And here is what you need to do in this season of transition. And I close. You need to have these four things: a certainty of God's voice, a clarity of vision, a boldness of faith, and a discipline of work. And watch God put you on a cloud of transition. And when it would have shooken you this time, because you're riding on that cloud and prepared and ready to take this transition, it's going to just float you to the next higher level in your life. I want you to believe that. I want you to receive that. God is taking you higher. This is your season of transition. Let's pray. Father, thank you for your word. We receive your word. I pray that this word will be on the hearts and minds of your people, that they may ponder enough to drive them to their knees so that they can have that certainty of your voice. That this word sits with them long enough so that drives them to a quiet spot so they can get clarity of vision. And then God, once they have certainty of your voice and clarity of your vision, that it doesn't stop there, but then they have boldness of faith, ready to be pushed over the edge so that they will not fall, but so that they will soar, fly like an eagle. And then God, they will exercise a discipline of work to walk in the blessings that has their name on it. You get the glory. You get the honor. We receive your word of transition now in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray. Amen. 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 Listen, I want to thank you so much for one, for joining us, and even a special thank you for those of you who are our faithful contributors, our faithful givers, and our faithful tithers. We are thriving because of you. Listen, don't ever believe that your help, there is no little. Your help, period, helps to do ministry for this church. So thank you so very, very much. So here is how you can continue to do that through your tithing and through your giving. There are a few ways that you can be a contributor to the kingdom of God through Life Church International. The first way is givelify.com. You can go to www.givelify.com, find our church name, which is Life Church International, and then you can give there for free. They will generate a receipt and acknowledgement that you have given. Thank you for those who are our faithful givelify.com contributors. Also, you can text to give. Text to give, just text this number, 845-244-4834. 845-244-4834. Same thing, very free platform, and it's a very simple way to give. The first time you give on this text to give, you're going to have to set up some things. It may take you all of 30 seconds to set it up, and then you're ready to go from there. The third way you can give is by mailing it in to our church office, Life Church International at 25 North Market Street, Suite 127, Jacksonville, Florida, 32202. I'll give that again, especially for those listening from conference call. Address Life Church International to the address 25 North Market Street, Suite 127, Jacksonville, Florida, 32202. Listen, once again, thank you so much for your gifts through tithing or through giving, just however you sow your seeds to the kingdom through Life Church International, we thank you. Can I pray with you over the offering? Father, we thank you for how you have blessed us financially. Thank you for giving us the right mind and principle of giving, knowing that your word says that as we give, you give back unto us good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, shall it return into our bosom. And Father, we receive that now in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray for that person even today who is giving through a sacrifice or it hurts to give. I pray, God, that they will not have many more days where it hurts to give, because as they give, you will meet them at their point of giving and you will shower down unto them blessings, God, so that they may have the means to give continually in the future. Thank you. Take our giving, multiply, increase, supply, and provide. In the mighty matchless name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Take a moment right now and type in the comments over your life. Multiply, increase, supply, and provide. Y'all know how we do. Come on, speak over your life. Speak over your finances. Multiply, increase, supply, and provide. One more time. Come on. I need you to type it right here in the comments and saying it on the conference call where you are. Multiply, increase, supply, and provide in Jesus' name. Amen. I receive that. I receive that. I receive that. All right, listen, there are some exciting things that are happening this particular month. This particular month, there's some very exciting things. The first thing that is exciting is that our eye care team has asked for all of our help. We have adopted our service location facility, which is Morris Manor. Morris Manor has about 178 residents there, and we want to be a blessing to them, not just because of the pandemic, but just a blessing to them year round. And so we, our care team rather, has put up an idea after connecting with the service coordinator there at Morris Manor to put together care boxes, all right? We're going to put together 178 care boxes. Here is what I'm asking from you. I'm asking that each family donates 5 boxes or either $40. We prefer the 5 boxes, but if you are unable to do the boxes, then we're asking that you give the $40. When you give the $40 on any of those platforms that I named moments ago, give the 5, text the give, or even through mailing it in, just denote on there Morris Manor Care Box, all right? Morris Manor Care Box. 5 boxes or $40. Here is what is to go into the boxes, all right? Hand sanitizer, disinfectant wipes, Lysol, crossword puzzles, small puzzles, pocket tissues, adult coloring books, and color pencils, and any other little trinkets you think should go in there, but make sure these are in there. Here on the screen again, I'll go over them with you again. Hand sanitizer, disinfectant wipes, Lysol, crossword puzzles, small puzzles, pocket tissues, adult coloring books, and color pencils. And once again, any other little trinkets you think are appropriate to go in there, please put those into the box. We had a deadline for September 15th. I want you all to try and meet that deadline. However, if that deadline does not suit you and you need to go a little past that deadline because that deadline is like right around the corner, then don't worry about that. I just need you to get the 178 boxes in. Make sure that you get those in. Listen, here's an all call to all of our distant Life Church International followers, our Life Church International members, and our partners that are all around. If you are in another city like Fort Pierce, Fort Lauderdale, Atlanta, Georgia. Listen, Tampa, Florida, we want you to share with us. I am challenging Fort Pierce, Fort Lauderdale, Atlanta, Georgia. I'm challenging Tampa, Florida. I'm challenging Pensacola. I'm challenging all of those persons that partner with us that are in those particular areas. I'm challenging you to take on 25 boxes, which means it's you and maybe about 4 or 5 other persons in that area, all right, that will take on this challenge to bring in 5 boxes from your area. I want for you guys to say, hey, Fort Pierce has 25 boxes. We got 25 boxes from Fort Lauderdale. We have 25 boxes from Tampa. We have 25 boxes from Atlanta, Georgia. We have 25 boxes from Pensacola, Florida. Listen, we can do this. We can do this. We can do this. As a matter of fact, I want you to type right here, yes, we can. Listen, we exist to serve, all right? So yes, we can. I don't hear nobody typing. Type, yes, we can. This is exactly what I want you to do. Eye care team needs your help, and we're going to do this and serve God's people. Not only that, but also this month, we have our third Wednesday Bible study. Our third Wednesday Bible study is September 16th at 7 o'clock p.m. on Facebook, which means that is this Wednesday coming up. this Wednesday, 7 o'clock p.m. is our third Wednesday night Bible study. I want you on so that you can hear the word of God and get your refueling, your rejuvenation in the middle of the week. Here's another thing that's very, very, very exciting. This month is the birth month of Life Church International. We turn 13 years old this month. September 21st is Life Church's birthday. September 20th, which is the day before that, is when we're going to celebrate at Morris Manor, which is our service location. Another drive-in service at 10 o'clock a.m. at Morris Manor. We want you in the place, all right? Everybody, here's what I want you to do. When you come for this particular celebration, everybody bring a balloon or two, either black, green, or white. Bring a black, green, or white balloon or two for when you come for our 13th year anniversary drive-in service at Morris Manor at 10 a.m. on that day. I'm going to say this now. I want to give a great shout-out celebration and birthday celebration to those who actually shared the birth date of our church. Miss Laura Phillips, Miss Arfing Anderson, Mr. Walter Holt. I hope I'm not missing nobody this time. I know Marquita's aunt, Auntie Georgia. These people all share the same exact birth date of our church, and we are very excited about our 13th year anniversary. All right. Those are all our announcements for this particular month. We're going to pray and be dismissed, and then we'll go from there. Father, thank you. Thank you, especially for the word of God. I pray, God, that you will just allow us to walk in it and allow us to be led by your spirit. I pray, Father, a great big thank you for keeping us 13 years. It has only been because of your grace and because of your mercy. I pray, God, that we will have an incredible week ahead of us and that you will bless us tremendously beyond our asking. Lift your hands now for the blessings of the Lord. May the Lord God bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. I speak a this week blessing over your life, that no matter what you've been going through, no matter what you've been believing for, whatever it is you stepped out on faith in will begin manifesting for you even this week. And I pray that no matter what obstacle, God will give you peace that surpasses all understanding. In the mighty matchless name of Jesus, we pray. Somebody type, I receive it in Jesus' name. Amen. Listen, guys, before you get off the live, make sure that you greet somebody, talk to somebody. Let me know how you feel if you were blessed. Listen, I love you with the love of Christ, and there's absolutely nothing you can do about it.
No more stressing.